We want to solve the system of three equations with three unknowns using the elimination method. To solve a system like this, we want to find the values of x, y, and z that would satisfy all three equations. And when solving a system like this, there are actually three possibilities. We can have one solution, no solution, or an infinite number of solutions. So before we solve this, to get a better understanding of this, if we graph these in space, each of these would be a plane. So if we graph three planes in space, there are three possibilities. As we see here, the planes could intersect in one point, which means the system would have one solution. So we can say the system is consistent and independent. We say consistent because it has a solution, and independent because it has one solution. But it's also possible if we graph three planes in space, there aren't any points that are on all three planes. Therefore, the system would have no solutions, and we can say the system is inconsistent. The third possibility is there are an infinite number of points on all three planes. As we see here, notice the three planes intersect in this yellow line, and there's an infinite number of points on a line, therefore we have an infinite number of solutions, so we can say the system is consistent and dependent. Again, consistent because it has a solution, and dependent because it has an infinite number of solutions. So before we solve our system, let's review the elimination method. The first step is to select any two equations and eliminate any one of the variables from the two equations. Then we'll select two other equations and eliminate the same variable again. This will give us two equations with two unknowns, which we'll solve using the elimination method and then perform back substitution to solve for all the variables. So for the first step, let's go ahead and label these equations so we can stay organized. Let's call this equation A, equation B, and equation C. We first want to select two equations and eliminate one of the variables. It doesn't matter which equations we select or which variable we want to eliminate. Let's go ahead and select equation B and C and eliminate the z terms. Notice how they're already opposite signs. So if this was plus 4z, we could add the two equations together and eliminate z. So let's go ahead and multiply equation C by 2 and add it to B. So we'll have 2 times equation C plus equation B. 2 times C would be 2x minus 2y plus 4z equals negative 8. We're going to leave equation B the same. And now we'll add the two equations. Notice that the z terms are opposites, therefore this sum would be 0. So we have 4x plus y equals negative 4. We'll use this equation again in just a moment. Now we'll select two other equations, but we do want to eliminate z again. So now let's use equation A and equation C. Again, notice how the z terms are opposites. So again, if this was plus 4z, and we added the two equations together, the z term would be eliminated. So we're going to multiply equation C by 2 again, but now add it to equation A. So now we'll have 2 times equation C plus equation A. We just multiplied equation C by 2. It was 2x minus 2y plus 4z equals negative 8. We're going to add this to equation A, which is 3x plus y minus 4z equals negative 6. So we'll add these two equations together. Notice how these z terms, again, are opposites. This would sum to 0. So we have 5x minus y equals negative 14. Notice what we've done now is we've created two equations with two unknowns, so we'll solve this as a system using elimination. So now we want to solve the system 4x plus y equals negative 4 and 5x minus y equals negative 14. Now we kind of lucked out here because notice how the y terms are already opposites. So we can add these two equations together and eliminate y. Sometimes this won't be the case, and we have to multiply one or both of the equations by a constant, so either the x or y terms would be opposites, similar to what we did over here for z. Well, here we can go ahead and add these equations. This would be 0, so we have 9x equals negative 18. Divide both sides by 9. So now we know that the x coordinate of our solution must be negative 2. But remember, we're not done. We're trying to find the x, y, and z value that satisfy this system. So now we'll perform back substitution to find y and z. To do this, we'll select an equation. To do this, we'll start by finding an equation that has just x and one other variable. So again, to keep organized, let's call this equation D and call this equation E. Notice if we used equation D, we could solve it for y by subtracting 4x on both sides. We can say y is equal to negative 4x minus 4. We can substitute negative 2 for x and solve for y. So y is equal to negative 4 times negative 2 minus 4. This would be positive 8 minus 4. So now we know y is equal to positive 4. Now we still have to find z. To do this, we'll go back to one of the original equations and substitute values for x and y so that we can find z. Let's go ahead and use equation c. So using equation c, you know x is negative 2, so we'd have negative 2 minus y, but y is 4, so minus 4 plus 2z must equal negative 4. Well, this would be negative 6 plus 2z equals negative 4. Add 6 to both sides. We have 2z equals positive 2. So z is equal to positive 1. So notice how this system has one solution, meaning that these three planes would intersect in the point where the x coordinate is negative 2, the y coordinate is positive 4, and the z coordinate is positive 1. And in fact, many times you'll see the solution given as an ordered triple. So we could say the solution is the point negative 2, 4, 1. And we'll go and take a look at this in just a moment. Again, if we graph this in space, we would have three planes. And we're saying that the point of intersection would be this point here. Well, here's the graph of the three planes in space. This point right here is our solution because it's the only point that's on all three planes. Let's go ahead and rotate this to the other side so we can see it again. Again, it would be this point that we see right here, which we found using the elimination method. I hope you found this example helpful. We'll take a look at several more examples in the next few videos.